Hi, my name is Liv, and today I will be taking you through my drawing process for designing a period costume. In this case, I am drawing completely digitally, using a Wacom tablet and Photoshop. Currently, digital drawing is my preferred medium, as I find it the most convenient and versatile form of rendering. My process will usually begin with a whole lot of research. For this particular drawing, I am diving into the world of French aristocrats, in the mid to late 1700s. I've decided to design a costume that is a hybrid of my favourite artwork, Van Gogh's sunflowers, and a period of history that fascinates me. My research will often take a number of forms. Some of my favourite sources include the Victorian Albert online collection, the Met Museum, and of course, books on fashion and costume history. I like to begin my process of drawing this style of costume by first understanding its anatomy. What made up a fashionable French outfit in 1776? What was underneath the layers of beautiful fabrics and vivid colours? This particular gown that I'm designing here is a robe à la Française, with an open robe and petticoat. This was the quintessential dress of the 18th century. The key characteristics of this gown is the low neckline, fitted bodice, narrow sleeves with double-layered cuffs, as well as the sack back and fullness at the hips, supported by panniers. Panniers give the garment their iconic wide silhouette. The dresses were comprised of a gown worn over a decorative stomacher, which is the V or U-shaped decorative panel at the front of the gown, a decorative underskirt, and plenty of bows, frills, and embellishments. This style of dress was hugely popular with upper-class and aristocratic circles. Marie Antoinette, the last queen of France, was known for having hugely extravagant versions of these dresses. Scandal followed Marie Antoinette throughout her time as queen. At the very core of her reign was her rebellion against the strict etiquette of the French monarchy, and her primary weapon of this rebellion was her fashion. Her choices were always scrutinized by both her fellow aristocrats and the French public alike. The final straw came when she was painted wearing what was considered a milkmaid's attire, sparking the feeling amongst the people that they were being mocked and betrayed by their leaders. Although Marie Antoinette's fashion is not the only reason for the French Revolution, her extravagant taste and controversial choices contributed to the French people's deep resentment for their leaders. Until her very last breath, Marie Antoinette used clothing as a statement. For me, costume is all about statement. It's a statement of who the character is, what their world looks and feels like, and how they intend to fit into it. In the case of this drawing, it's more of a statement of who I am as a designer, combining a love of history and fine art to create something that I feel really excited talking about with others. Thank you for joining me on this drawing journey. I hope you learnt something that excites you.